Let's take a look at the talent tape for this special feature attraction. Tabarov, 12 years younger than Lopes. Lopes got the 2-inch height advantage. Like I said, both guys making their debuts. With that, let's throw up to the center of the cage. Mark Fratos, the official introduction.
Ladies and gentlemen, the action continues from right here in the center of the cage, live at the space at Westbury. This is Triton Fights 10, presented by Tiger Life Energy. Tiger Life Energy has never tasted so good. This next bout is a special feature, scheduled for 3 rounds in the featherweight novice division. It's presented by Tiger Life Energy and brought to you by Roar Organics. Reset, refresh, rejuvenate. The Meal Kitchen, the official meal prep of Triton Fights. Footlux of Long Island, sports medicine that helps improve athletic performance. LI Live Cryotherapy and Wellness. Virtual Realms, Beyond Average, and Cannes Sports Bar of Westbury, your official destination after the fights. The judges are seated cage side and controlling the action at the sound of the bell. The referee in charge is Chris Molina. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands at 5'6" and weighed in at 142 pounds. He wears gray, white, and black as he makes his debut this evening. Hailing from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, and representing NPR Endurance Philly, please welcome Dovud Tabarov. His opponent across the cage fights out of the red corner. He stands at 5'8" and weighed in at 141 pounds. He wears black with red as he makes his debut this evening, hailing from nearby Huntington, Long Island, and representing Gracie Barra, please welcome Philippe Lopes.
Tell you what, guys, that was one of the most intense pre-fight introductions in terms of each fighter staring at each other down. Looks like Lopes has already went like 3 rounds just in stare downs. But I tell you what, he takes that black belt into the cage. Lopes in the black and red, Tabarov in the black and gray. Your third man in the cage, referee Chris Molina. We're underway in this special feature attraction.
Well, right away, something to take note of based on the novice rule set. The rule set's gonna favor the black belt once it hits the ground. It's essentially a jiu-jitsu match when it's on the ground because you can't really strike to the head.
That's why I was surprised that Lopes came out swinging. Not been looking to score a takedown. And as I say that,
well, that's the thing. Your black belt is a very big advantage, but you got to get the fight to the ground to execute that advantage.
Yeah, I'm not sure what Tabarov's wrestling experience is, but he definitely hasn't. He's definitely doing what he has to do to keep it on his feet. Landed a couple good punches early on, sort of stuck Lopes, and made him initiate the clinch early on. And now they're just stuck in this position here.
You know, Tabarov took this fight on. I'm sorry, Dave. Tabarov took this fight on just a week's notice.
Ooh.
His brother MJ didn't even ask him if he wanted the fight. He said yes, we'll take it. When matchmaker Chris Machi, and he drops him with a left hand. Tabarov drops Lopes, and Lopes is in trouble.
If I'm Tabarov here, I wouldn't even follow him to the ground.
Yeah, just get right back up.
Set, right back up. You can see why he took this fight on short notice. He looks very crisp on the hands.
Look at this. Lopes got an ankle lock.
But in the novice rule set, you're not allowed to do any types of twisting ankle locks. So that really inhibits your ability to finish from this position here.
Great action here in round number one, Eric.
Yeah, Tabarov here landed a couple good shots, was able to drop Lopes. But now he's got to get back on the feet. Following him down is a big mistake, like Dave said earlier. You drop somebody in this novice rule set, you want to make them get back up.
Yeah. This rule set does not favor Tabarov right now the way he can strike. You know, if he could have followed him and followed up with shots to the ground, we might be looking at a different story here in this fight.
And it's been about 30 seconds since that, or 45 seconds since Lopes got rocked. Maybe he was able to collect his thoughts.
His equilibrium still looks a little bit off.
Yeah, it does. His legs are a little wobbly. As Tabarov lands another right hand, partially landed.
Tabarov definitely has some striking experience.
Yeah.
Pretty good striking experience. He looks very comfortable on his feet.
Kovarov misses with a big swinging right, and that goes right into Lope's wheelhouse with the takedown here. He's got 30 seconds to work.
Still, he's got full guard, 23 seconds left. Not a lot of time for Lopes to work from the top. And getting knocked down once in this round and caught another couple of times, I mean, I think it's a pretty safe to say that the judges are going to score this for Kovarov.
And even on his back right now, Kovarov looks just cool, calm, and collected, relaxed. He doesn't look very phased at all.
He's just sort of rolling around. It's actually sort of like his interesting look on his face.
Big smile.
As opposed to Lope's real angry eye look. You can get a big Chanel, I get a store if you want. And I gave him a jewel, they said it up, I got him on.
I bought a new bag, I had a wife, I watch him turn. Take any drugs, I'm gonna be up until the morning. Great round from Kovarov, who took the fight on 4 days' notice. You can see that he's getting instructions from his brother MJ. His brother MJ got the call from our Triton Fights matchmaker, Chris Machi, and he didn't even ask his brother if he wanted the fight. He said, yes, we'll take it. And he just told him, you're fighting in 3 days.
I would assume that Kovarov has some type of kickboxing experience.
Yeah, he's been training for over 6 years.
Maybe he was hoping to get on another fight. Around another fight card around the same time, because he seems like he's in pretty good shape too.
I think we're gonna see that knockdown. There it was an overhand left from Kovarov that landed right on the mark. Pick up the action here in round number two. This is a bantamweight special feature. Felipe Lopes in the black and red. Dovu Kovarov in the black and gray. In the first round, you saw some great handwork from Kovarov dropping Lopes with an overhand left. Lopes is the black belt. He wants to take this fight to the ground. I'm going to poke in the eye. I think he thumbed him.
I saw that. That definitely made some contact. It looked like it pushed his eye a little bit. That did not look fun.
Let's see if Kovarov, if it blows up. I've seen in boxing where guys get thumbed and the eye can just blow up, because that is a very tender area around the eye.
You know, Kovarov sort of leads with his head forward a little bit, sort of trying to bait Lopes in, and then counter punches him when he puts his hands out or tries to strike when he's like aiming for the head of Kovarov. So like, that open hand, when you reach like that, makes you super susceptible to pokes.
Nice right hand from Lopes. Tell you what,
Lopes. Ooh, big counter from Kovarov.
For a guy with a black belt, Lopes is very comfortable on his stand-up. I'm surprised he's not going for the takedown every single time.
Well, I think that he is. He's just having a real difficult time getting in to get it. Yeah.
He's doing the right thing. You know, he came forward behind the striking to close that distance, though. He's definitely making the in-fight adjustments that are necessary.
Do you guys find a lot of times where a guy who has a black belt and is so skilled in that area wants to prove to everyone that I'm more than just a one, you know, I'm more of a three-dimensional fighter, multi-dimensional fighter?
Not when you're 0-0. You're just trying to win.
True.
Well, you see that a lot. You know, you see that at all levels. You've seen guys like Josh Koscheck, who's the wrestler who fell in love with his striking, and kind of abandoned
it. That's what I mean. It's like
you had Ben Askren talk about that, how he abandoned his wrestling a little bit and affected some of his performances. So people do get sidetracked sometimes and forget about the pony that brought him to the show.
Nice that sweep. Work. Beautiful work from Lopes. Trying to fight now and getting a full guard.
This time they're in the center, so Kovarov doesn't have the fence to climb up to get back to his feet.
And he's got a minute and 20 seconds here. Novice rules, of course, you cannot strike to the head when you're on the ground, only body work.
Now, the one thing about your jiu-jitsu is with these shin pads, the friction that it creates trying to pass this position here, the half guard, it gets tricky with those shin pads and the friction they cause.
It is, but those shin guards actually work to Lopes' advantage, because Kovarov wasn't able to get away.
As Lopes get into full guard here.
Looks like he's trying to set up an Ezekiel choke from the top here. Yep, he's looking to get an Ezekiel choke right now. He's got that right arm under his neck and the left arm across over his neck.
Kovarov in a very bad situation here with 30 seconds remaining here in round number two. We're scheduled for three. This is a Bantam special feature. Great back and forth action. First round kind of dominated by Kovarov. This second round I would put into the category of Lopes. Yeah,
just
the
under
edge.
Control here. 10 seconds. Lopes is looking to get that mounted Ezekiel choke. That's a tough choke to get with these gloves.
Move on to round number three. Take a look at some of the replay from that second round, where Lopes kind of got back to what he does well, and that's get on the ground and kind of dominate from there.
Taborov landed a couple of shots, and Lopes sort of like
ladies
went to the
and gentlemen,
and
let's
him.
Get a big Long Island like round of applause legs. For these two making their debuts this evening as we head into round number three, the third and final round.
Third and final round here from the space at Westbury. Nice overhand right lands from Taborov. He's been able to land those throughout the fight. Taborov in the gray and white, Lopes in the black and red.
You see Lopes, he's doing the right thing. He's coming forward trying to close that distance, and he's coming behind his jab. Even just feinting it out there, it's giving Taborov something to think about at least.
First two rounds have been very competitive. You can make a case for Taborov taking the first round. Also make a case for Lopes taking that second round. So this one could be up in the air as we get underway here in the third round.
Yeah, this round is going to decide this fight. If Taborov is able to keep his distance and land his strikes like he's doing right now, he's going to get this round and get the win. If Lopes is able to get the fight to the ground, then he'll probably get the decision.
We got some real vocal fighters in there tonight. Everybody's talking to each other and posturing. There hasn't been one fight without some type of gesturing or, you know, finger punches and
that's
birds.
That just shows me, like, confident fighters. Taborov doing what he's been doing the majority of this fight. That's landing that right hand. He's got Lopes all sorts of confused up there.
Lopes keeps talking shit, and then Taborov just whacks him again.
Taborov walking back, hands down, backpedaling.
90 seconds remaining here, round number three. Duvaux Taborov in the black and the gray and white. He's been finding a home for that overhand right. If you're Felipe Lopes, I'll ask you this, Dave. You got a minute 18 left here. Fight's hanging in the balance. Go for a takedown.
You know, I think he's got to put a punch, you know, an exclamation point on his run. There it is on cue, but he pulls his opponent onto full mount here.
Well, here's a position that Taborov hasn't been in. That's been, you know, on top.
You know, he's trying to go for a knee bar here. And he's using those shin guards for extra leverage to hold on. That extra friction really makes a big difference. Makes it very difficult to get up.
Taborov just posturing, playing in the crowd.
Referee Chris Molina is getting the thrill, like a little smirking.
He's saying leg locks don't work.
I'm not exactly telling him to stop, referee Chris Molina.
It's interesting to note here, you know, if this was a different rule set, Lopes could be in trouble in this position. He could be, you know, having to worry about ground and pound.
Two extremely confident fighters for making their debuts, wouldn't you say?
Absolutely. You can tell these guys got a lot of experience behind them. They've both been training for a long time. And Taborov has definitely been in the ring before. He had to have had some kickboxing experience, I would say.
10 seconds here. We're going to go to the scorecards in another competitive fight here at Triton Fight 10. Who do you think won, Eric?
I mean, that was a little bit of a tough third round to judge, but, I mean, Lopes didn't really have any really great submission attempts. He had one knee bar that was sort of loose and shaken off by Taborov rather easily. And Taborov definitely, I don't want to say got the better of, I think he landed all of the strikes in that round. So I mean, I'm pretty confident in saying that I think that Pavrov won the first and the third, so I think it's going to be a decision of his for Pavrov in that one.
I tend to agree with you there. I think that Lopes, when he goes back and looks at the tape, he's going to be a little disappointed that he didn't kind of go to his strengths a little more.
You know, he had a real difficult time scoring the takedowns.
Right.
All of the, every time they ended up on ground, it was they just sort of ended up there, and he was latched onto Tavrov's legs and dragged him down.
You got to give credit to Dobro Tavrov, who took this fight on 4 days' notice. There he is with his brother MJ. He's two confident guys. When I was talking to him before the fight. We'll see who comes out with their first win of their career. And a lot of fans came here to see Felipe Lopes. But you just heard a nice ovation for Tavrov, and he won over some of the crowd.
Definitely an exciting fight.
Let's throw it up to the center of the cage. Mark Fratto, he's got the official result.
Ladies and gentlemen, here on Long Island, let's get a big West Ferry round of applause for these two making their career debut this evening. Having gone the three-round distance, we now go to the judges' scorecards. Judge A saw the action 29-28 in favor of Felipe Lopes. Judge C scored it 29-28 in favor of Dovud Tavrov. And Judge B scored this one 29-28 in favor of your winner by split decision. From Huntington, Long Island, Felipe.